Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I actually wanted to review another watercolor which I have been using for almost 1 month or I don't know, maybe 2 months. So I don't remember exactly the date when I purchased the watercolor. So I'll be showing you the Tamlin watercolor review, and it's a 24 shade palette. Usually you will get the 18 shade palette in the market. I've done a review on that, you can check it out, I'll leave the link down below. So yeah, let's begin with the review. So this is how the palette looks like. As you can see, it's a standard Camlin palette. The 18 shade one actually had illustrations on them and it was colorful, but this is 24 shades. It's artist watercolor cake, so it's artist grade watercolor. And when you, it's quite bigger than the 18 shade one, and when you open it up, it's like a tin box. You can see here, it's the normal tin box packaging, and when you open it up, you'll see this. You'll have this the names of the colors written, and the names are corresponding to this, like it's written here, this one is black and this one is white. This one is actually white, I've used it, so it's turned out to be a different color. So they have written down the name and they place it like this, and it comes with a like a cardboard thing. I've swatched it actually, so but still I'll be swatching it for you guys, so just stay tuned for that. So here you can see they've written the names: black, white, indigo, caramel, burnt umber. So I'll refer to this card and I'll tell you which color is which, and I'll swatch it to you and show it to you. So yeah, and apart from that, it comes with a really nice brush. This time they have given a really nice brush. Let me just show you. So it's made out of synthetic hair. It's Camlin. Let me just show. Just focus it. So Camlin synthetic hair brush. It's a very nice brush, and it comes with a cover, and you can see how nice and fine the tip is. You can actually use it for lining your artwork. It looks like a liner brush to me, so I've actually used it as a liner brush. It works really well. So usually I don't use brushes, but whatever is given in the palette, but this time I feel like the brush quality is much nicer. So let's begin with the swatching. So the first color is orange, and this is how it looks after spreading. And since it is artist grade, you can see how smooth the color is. It's pretty smooth, and the pigmentation is also really nice. This is what I really like about this brand. I don't know why some people prefer Winsor & Newton and other foreign brands, but this Indian brand also does really great when it comes to making colors. So here you can see scarlet. It's quite bright, and when you swatch it this way by fading it, you can see the difference for yourself, how light it can go from dark to light. So that was scarlet. And then moving on with the other color, this is light red. I really like this shade, and this shade is actually a very pigmented shade in the palette. And you can see here, it's a very beautiful earthy tone color, and it's really good for illustrations of dinosaurs, or maybe animal illustrations which you do, the realistic drawings, you can actually use this. So apart from that, you have the next color is crimson. You can see how beautiful the colors are. Colors are quite nice, vibrant, and swatch it lightly, you see the pigmentation there. So you can see how beautifully it fades. On with the next color here, it's lemon yellow, and I really like the palette more than the 18 shade one. I don't know why, maybe because it has a lot of colors and I don't have to actually mix a lot of colors, so that is one thing which led me to buy this palette, and that is the reason why I bought this. So the next color here is Gamboge hue. I've written the name so that you can actually know which color I'm painting, shading off. So Gamboge hue is a kind of a golden yellow color. This is a very different shade of yellow. This is a different shade of yellow. Next color here is the Indian yellow. You can see it has more orange added to it. This Indian yellow color was not there in the previous palette, and you can easily make out the difference between the three colors. Here you can see this yellow and this last yellow, so you can easily make out the difference. So moving on with the next color, this is a yellow ochre color. I really like the earthy tones in this palette. This palette actually has really nice and amazing earthy tones. If you are into earthy tones, I would recommend this palette, and overall I feel the colors are really nice for illustration. And there you go, yellow ochre. Moving on to the next one. So I have sap green here. So this is sap green, and then the lighter version of sap green. Then you have viridian blue, viridian hue actually, not blue, viridian hue. Watch it, it looks like this. So the next color here is Hooker's green. This color was not present previously. This is a new addition to this 24 shade palette. So Hooker's green, and then there's this shade, and you can see the difference in the three shade: sap green, viridian hue and Hooker's green. All of these are really different. This is more of an earthy green color. The next shade here is emerald green, and it is actually a really nice emerald color, a very true emerald color, I would say. Moving on with the next color, cobalt, I have cerulean blue hue. This is the blue shade, and this is how it looks if you swatch it. Then you have cobalt blue hue. next color is ultramarine blue. Ultramarine blue, actually I've written it wrong, it's ultramarine blue. Again, this is a very, I would say, earthy toned blue. I would say ultramarine blue is a very earthy toned blue. So the next color we have here is violet. This is again another new addition to this palette. And all the colors in this palette are pretty vibrant and pretty amazing. I would highly recommend this palette to anyone starting out with watercolors. If you are from India, or even if you are not from India, I would recommend this palette because it is a very affordable palette with very great color qualities, like very great pigmented colors. Then the next color is burnt umber, and in this palette they've given all earthy tones, which is really nice, which I really appreciate. Usually you have to go and buy different tubes if you are working with tube watercolors. Personally, I prefer the pan one, the pan artist watercolors, because they are easy to carry anywhere, and that is burnt umber. Next one is my favorite color of all, and I use this color a lot, burnt sienna. And you can see it's quite a beautiful color. And then here again we come to raw umber. Raw umber is very similar to yellow ochre color, but yeah, it has a yellowish tinge to it. So that is raw umber. And then the last color here is this color, which is raw sienna. All of the colors are pretty smooth when it comes to using it. So just shifting the color palette here. Next color we have here is carmine. It's a very beautiful color. Again, you can see the pigmentation. And then when you do this, you can see how nicely it spreads. Next color is indigo. This is again a new shade to the palette. Indigo, another earthy toned color. Then we have white. I've heard many people say that white should not be added to watercolor palette. I feel white is given in a watercolor palette so that you can make other colors lighter, so that you can use it for mixing it with other colors rather than using it separately as a white color. And you can see here white. I don't know if it's visible on camera or not, but to me it's visible, and if you swatch the color white over the written part, you can see how opaque the color is. You can actually look at the opacity of the color. So for me, white is, I often use white for mixing it with other colors, like burnt sienna, for making skin color out of burnt sienna. So that is what I do. And then the last color you have is black, and this black color is so black that I can actually use it for Inktober, and I don't have to buy any other color. So there's that, and that was the swatches. I'll show you the overall view of the swatches. So this is how the swatches look. You can see how nice the color variations are, and I really like this palette. For me, it's a win-win. I would give it a 5 out of 5. I don't find any problem with this palette. So let me just show you another test, so that you can actually come to know how well the color mix with each other. So let's zoom in and let's just try mixing two colors, and two of my favorite colors, that is burnt sienna with any other color. Here I'm adding burnt sienna, and then I'm taking a little bit of Indian yellow ochre color, golden yellow, and then I'm mixing it up, and you can see there how nicely it spreads. I really like this quality in watercolor. They should merge immediately and very nicely. So let me swatch this, mix another color. Adding indigo, and then I'm mixing the one color with the other. And you can see how well the colors have mixed up. Let's just do another test here. I'm adding a little bit of water, and let's see how the color spread. I'm adding using red color, scarlet red. You can see here how nicely the colors spread. In water, So overall, I feel that this palette is an amazing one. I think you should definitely buy this one. I'm not advertising anything, but I truly feel that you should give this palette a try. If you are using Camlin watercolors in tube form, even then you should try the cake watercolor cake one, because it's very travel friendly and it has a lot of color which are really great and really pigmented. So yeah, stay tuned for my next video. Till then, have a nice day. Do subscribe, like, and share this video. Till then, I'll see you in my next video.